know, and it sounded like the guy was in partnered with another guy in Woodinville, Washington, that later, I believe, bought out, Jim Musser, bought him out, and then it became Solid Boatworks, which they only produced a few hulls. There's a holy Kodiak like that, and I knew it was the same hull.
That'll be darn.
I mean,
better than I
did. I dug around on the internet and looked a little bit more.
So they set up for freezing.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. It's got a little different freezer system. He's got a plate freezer system in it. Well,
there she is, huh?
Yeah. Look at that nice tall bow.
Yeah. It's like 2.5 fishtail bows right there.
That's pretty typical of them Mussers, how they have that sort of flared bow. Right?
Yeah,
it is. That's exactly how. So the one in Kodiak is tall.
Oh, it's a
Yeah, it's completely, completely different trim. I think his bow might even be up a little bit more, but this, you know, the stern is down.
I might have saw that boat when I bought this one. There was a there was a schooner type design hull like this.
Yeah.
When I was getting hauled out, and I talked to the guy for a little while, but I think there were a few of those. The only reason I left them on the cockpit covers on there is to keep the mink out.
Oh.
I have not had any mink trouble, but no. I certainly don't want mink trouble.
Yeah, they're kind of nasty critters.
They are. They'll get and chew your wiring and everything else.
Just like a rat.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. I have a starter button here. Just checking well.
The fire's right up. Yeah, it's very clean.
This thing here, you have to go into neutral before you go into forward or reverse.
Okay.
If you don't, when I first bought it, I'm going reverse, reverse, reverse. I'm coming into the float, right?
Nothing
and
happens.
Nothing happens until you go into neutral.
Remember last time we had like a wave break over the rail or anything, because you know, we just cork up and over it.
Is yeah,
right. Kind of favor this side, it gets a little shallow over there. You used to know it's more out a little bit. Yeah, you can kind of see boat came in here in the middle of the night. It's a little Hoquiam came in here in the middle of the night. He was crabbing and he ran right up on the beach instead of going in the harbor,
parked right there.
Yeah. Another guy went and got ice, and he was drifting out here, and he thought he was in neutral. He went down below to kind of shovel ice, came back up, and he was up on Graveyard Island.
Oh, no.
I said, you better start leaving our ancestors alone. He was the butt of jokes for months. He was like, everybody called him Clam Digger.
Oh, my gosh.
Heck of a way to dig clams. Out of here. I was just going to go up into Port Frederick a little ways. I can feel that the bottom is much cleaner. When I went over to the haul out, holy cow, the prop had a lot of barnacles on it. You could just feel it. I was running a high RPM just to get moving at all, you know.
very nice. It's been quaint. I like it.
Me too.
It's quiet.
Just like we like it.
I like all the little boats. It's just neat.
Yeah, I do too. A working man, huh?
Yep. Think.
Nice and smooth, huh?
Yeah. What do you think, T?
It's big and comfortable.
Yeah, I agree. Cruising 7.4 at 13.
Yeah.
She turns fast. Back into the harbor here. A little boat ride.
It was nice.
Yeah, she rides nice.
Hot tea.
Mm-hmm.
It's coming around the corner here.
probably go around this side of that pin there. I gotta move forward quite a ways.
Okay. I tossed these out.
I've got plenty of buoys.
We don't have any on our boat.
We have some buoys on the
top. Is that right?
Yeah.
A nice day, good lunch and tour of the harbor.
Mm-hmm.
Yep,
been fun looking around.
Yeah, owner took us out on a little spin this morning. Sounds real good, runs nice, quiet. Yeah, a few modifications. I think it'll suit us pretty well.